Hello and welcome to a brand new season of Study Abroad Canada Insights series. I'm your host Rahul and I'm from IDP. This year we have got another set of experts who would be happy to answer all your questions. So what are your overall thoughts on Canadian education? Can you share some success stories of Indian students?
And all these programs are affordable? How expensive can it get?
Do all students really get work permit?
Is there any financial assistance, scholarships available to international students?
Keep watching this space for more information. I'll see you soon.
Hello and welcome to an all-new episode of Canada Insights series. My name is Rahul and we have a very special guest here today, Mr. Robert Perrier from Lakehead University. Robert, welcome to our show.
Thank you for having me.
How are you?
Doing very well, thank you.
Would you like to introduce yourself to our audience? What do you actually do at the university?
So my name is Robert Perrier. I'm the Director of International Enrollment at Lakehead University. And my job is to oversee all of the recruitment, marketing, and outreach that we do around the world to help promote and raise awareness about Lakehead University.
Sounds like a very interesting job. I'm sure it entails a lot of traveling.
It does. We're fortunate to have, though, quite a large team that supports all those efforts, but I do have the opportunity to come and visit them, like I am here right now in India, taking some time to be here in the country, meet with families and students. So it is an intense role, but at the same time, because I love Lakehead and everything that has to do with Lakehead, it's a great enjoyment, and I'm very fortunate to have the opportunity to see and do the things that I do every day.
Fantastic. I'm sure meeting so many wonderful people is fantastic, but do you really like it, traveling so much?
I do. I love it. I mean, the world is such a fascinating place. But what I've learned over the years in all the different locations that I've been to is that, you know, at the end of the day, we're all people. And, you know, everyone has their fears, their anxieties, their dreams, and all the goals that they want to achieve. And so I love the opportunity to meet with those people, to talk about what their goals are and what their dreams and aspirations are, not only for students, but also for their families, who are a key part of the decision-making process in terms of choosing a university and where to go to school and study. So it's a great privilege that I have the opportunity to do this kind of work.
Wonderful. So when you started out, what drove you to be part of an international education segment?
Well, I've been with Lakehead University for quite a number of years. I've actually been working with university now for 16 years.
Wow.
But before that, I was also a student at Lakehead. So I have the unique perspective of being an alumni, having studied mathematics, English, as well as education. And when I completed my studies, I had this wonderful opportunity to join the university to help promote Lakehead within Canada and domestically.
So here at IDP, we also think of ourselves as experts. We know quite a bit about international education and about Canadian education, but in this episode, we would like to understand your perspective. So what are your overall thoughts on Canadian education?
Canada is, it is seen as a leader in the world in terms of education. Part of why that leadership happens is our education system is founded on a public system of education. So the kinds of quality assurance, you know, that students and parents can feel confident that when you study in Canada, not only will you receive a quality education, you'll have wonderful opportunities to develop yourself as a person, but also in terms of your employment skills. But those credentials will also be recognized around the world.
Right.
And so that is something that really assures people. Canada is a very safe and welcoming environment. Our history of being a multicultural society and welcoming people from around the world. So in terms of the lifestyle that students are looking for, the kinds of opportunities they want, you know, we have all the variety of options for them. Mm-hmm. But we also offer, you know, very clean, safe living environments. Canada's very fortunate to not have some of the challenges with pollution and things like that that many parts of the world do face.
Absolutely.
So even in terms of health and quality of life, there's so many options available to them.
And when it comes to career choices and program options available to international students, how does Lakehead help students choose what they want?
Well, at Lakehead, we recognize that the whole purpose of pursuing higher education is to ultimately prepare yourself for a career. There is, of course, the intrinsic value of getting a degree and expanding your knowledge, but the reality is, at the end of the day, we all want to make sure that we can have successful careers when we graduate. Canada as a country overall has very low unemployment, and so there's many opportunities for students. And the Canadian government also has postgraduate work permits that allow students to stay in Canada and to start their careers. We have a career center on campus that can help students look for and prepare to apply for part-time employment opportunities, whether that be on or off campus. And then as students prepare to finish their degrees and look to enter into more of a career-related discipline, we have huge job fairs where employers actually come to campus to recruit our students. We also can help them with resume development, job searches, interview preparation. We have a full career and co-op center right on campus.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. And that's quite a bit of hand-holding, and I'm sure international students appreciate that. So would you like to tell us more about Lakehead University?
So Lakehead University, we are a university in the province of Ontario. We're part of the Ontario Public University System. And so that's a really, you know, great reassurance to folks in terms of the quality of education that we offer and the quality assurance that exists within our province. Our university is sort of a small, medium-sized institution. And we have right now about 8,600 students that study at Lakehead.
Wow.
We have two campuses. Our main campus is located in beautiful Thunderbay, Ontario, which is in northwestern Ontario. We also have a smaller campus in Orillia, Ontario, which is just north of the city of Toronto. In terms of students at Lakehead, as I mentioned, we have about 8,600 students overall, and about 1,300 of those students are international, and they come from 83 different countries around the world. So it really is a diverse global learning environment at Lakehead.
Fantastic. So when students meet you for the first time, do they ask you questions about the city of Thunder Bay? Would you like to tell us more about the city?
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm fortunate to be able to say I'm born and raised in Thunder Bay, so I'm an authentic Northwestern Ontarian. And Thunder Bay is a wonderful city located in Northwestern Ontario. It is located right on the head of Lake Superior, which is the world's largest freshwater lake.
Wow.
We're also surrounded by the boreal forest. So when you think of Canada and all of the beautiful natural environment, you know, all of the outdoor experiences, that is, we live and breathe that every single day where we are. Thunder Bay is also the largest city in that region of Canada. So it is everything that a big city has, just on a bit of a smaller scale. So everything from arts, culture, entertainment, recreation, you name it, everything is available to students. It's very easy to get around the city. Commutes, there's not a lot of heavy traffic. Very good high quality, you know, air quality, you name it. It's a wonderful place to grow up and certainly to go to school. Our community in Orillia, which is just over an hour north of Toronto, it has about 35,000 people that live there. It's a nice small sort of community. It's the place where people from the big city go to relax and enjoy the outdoors.
That's super.
So it's the place where people go to have that lifestyle, and you can actually live there and learn there in that community as well. But it's very easy to get to our communities. So as I mentioned, Orillia is just north of Toronto, so it's about an hour and 15 minute drive if you're heading north. To get to Thunder Bay, it's about a 1 hour and 30 minute airplane flight from the city of Toronto.
Okay.
And there can be up to 16 flights a day between the cities. So it's very easy and very inexpensive to get to and from Toronto and Thunder Bay.
Sounds exciting. So coming back to the institution, so what are the program options which are available to international students?
We have 10 different faculties of study at Lakehead, and they range anywhere from the arts and the humanities to the traditional science and environmental programs. We also have professional degrees in business, engineering, education, natural resources management. We have all of the health programs and behavioral sciences, graduate studies, of course, and we also have a medical school and a law school at Lakehead. So in terms of that broad diversity, everything and anything is available with Lakehead.
That's awesome. So these are a lot of programs to choose from. And all these programs are affordable? How expensive can it get?
Yeah, so if you look at Lakehead in terms of the cost of our tuition, we're in the mid to mid-low range compared across the province of Ontario.
Okay.
So for undergraduate students, tuition can range to roughly just over $23,000 to around $28,000 Canadian dollars, depending on the program that a student is studying in. Our master's programs range between just over $22,000 to the highest being $36,000, which is the MBA. But again, when you compare that to prices of other programs in other parts of Ontario, it's actually quite affordable. But the other side around affordability is the cost of living. Yeah. And of course, in Canada, we have some very affordable cities, like the communities that we come from. But you'll also find Canada has very expensive cities as well, some of those larger metropolitan areas. And so by coming to a smaller city, the cost of living is actually much less when you look at the cost for rent and other expenses that you would have. So therefore, Lakehead actually becomes a very affordable option for students.
Right. And is there any financial assistance scholarships available to international students? And do you also have country-specific scholarships? For example, some scholarships which are only for Indian students?
So at Lakehead, we sort of look at things from an equitable standpoint. So we actually have a wonderful scholarship program targeting our undergraduate students. So this is not just specific to India, but in fact from students from all around the world. We offer entrance scholarships to any student who's coming into one of our undergraduate degree programs. And at the time of admission, we are going to convert their grades into a Canadian equivalent average. Starting with a 75% or higher, we automatically award scholarships, starting with $4,000 with a 75. And once you have an 80 or higher, your scholarship actually becomes renewable. So with an 80%, that would be a $20,000 Canadian scholarship, payable at $5,000 for 4 years. And with a 90% or higher, it's a $30,000 scholarship, $7,500 for 4 years. So very good financial aid options available to students based on their grades and their academic performance.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
So we keep on hearing about upcoming changes in the international education arena in Canada. So do you have any information about that? Do you see any upcoming rules, changes in regulations for international students?
Nothing right now. Like, I think that right now Canada has positioned itself in terms of opportunities for students, both within the country coming to Canada, but also after they graduate. And so at this time, we anticipate that to continue. In fact, what we've seen is at the federal government level, we've seen increasing investment in promoting Canada and helping to make sure as many people know about the opportunities that are available in our country. And so we would expect that will continue going forward.
Right. So IDP and Lakehead have been associated for quite some time.
Mm-hmm.
And we at IDP feel that our bond is really strong and we are both able to help students really well. What are your thoughts on it?
Absolutely. I've had an opportunity now to not only meet with yourself, but all of the teams here with IDP in India, but also around the world. And IDP really is a leader when it comes to supporting students and families. And so we're absolutely thrilled to be working together. And we see not only the quality of the students that come forward through the IDP network, but we also see the quality of supports that you're providing to your students. And so we're also very pleased with the relationship. And we are very confident that when students and families choose to work with IDP, they're going to get, you know, industry-leading service and supports. Philosophically, probably Lakehead and IDP, we have a lot of the same philosophies because Lakehead really is a student-centered institution. Similar to the way IDP operates, Lakehead is the same way. Our policies, our practices, the kinds of supports that we put forward is really to help each individual student succeed.
In India, we have this culture that companies would come to the campus and hire students from the campus. Does that happen at Lakehead University as well?
Yeah, absolutely. So the Student Success Center, one of the things that they do every year is they run 4 different massive career fairs on campus, starting in the fall and all the way throughout the academic year. At each of those fairs, employers come from within the local community, but also from across Canada and internationally to recruit students. So some of those employers are looking for sort of general employment. They have part-time positions, opportunities, but many of them have career jobs, looking for full-time employees from particular disciplines or areas. For instance, engineering students, they have their own entire fair just for engineers because those companies come to recruit students directly from the campus itself. But in terms of part-time employment though, you know, we encourage students to get out there, to walk into those businesses, meet the local manager, drop off a resume, you know, and solicit that opportunity that's out there. So there's many different experiences for them, but Lakehead absolutely opens the doors as best as we can to support students in that search.
That's amazing. I'm sure our students will definitely appreciate that.
Oh yes.
And we also keep hearing a lot about co-op. What is co-op?
So cooperative education is where an academic program creates opportunities for students to do a work placement or work internship within the academic program itself. Co-ops, what I love about co-ops is that not only are students getting work experience, but it is work experience that is tailored to the discipline in which they're studying. That work experience is monitored carefully. So not only is the employer evaluating the student, mentoring them, and giving them special attention because they are learning, right? They're still a student, they're still developing their skills. But that information also flows back into the academic program where professors and co-op monitors are also overseeing that as well. So it's a very supportive working environment where students not only are getting work experience, but they're actually being monitored and making sure that their development as a student is absolutely at the forefront. And all of those co-op experiences are approved by the faculty, so mm-hmm. they do directly attach towards their academic degree programs.
Wow.
And they're paid. So again, another benefit as well.
So all programs at Lakehead offer co-op opportunities?
Unfortunately, not all of them do, but a number of programs do. Okay. And in particular, those programs that are of interest, we find with students from India. So for instance, our Faculty of Business, Faculty of Engineering, Computer Science degrees, these all feature up to 20 months of paid co-op work experience built into their academic degree program. Well, what we find is, right now, when we look at the statistics of our students graduating, is 95.4% of students are getting employment within 2 years of graduation in their field of study. And so that is actually above the provincial average in Ontario when you compare the institutions. So students are doing really well. Some of our programs have 100% employment, you know, based on some of the science areas,
right.
the natural resources. Some of these sectors are clamoring for students to come and work in those areas. And then it fluctuates every year based on each year. But overall, when we look at those statistics, again, we see that above the provincial average, our students are gaining employment mm-hmm. and they're successfully starting their careers.
That's very nice. Mm-hmm. And I'll circle back to the point that we were earlier discussing. So you talked in detail about the business division. What are some of the other programs which are extremely popular with Indian students?
So after business, I would say the next most popular is engineering.
Right, obviously.
And Lakehead has a very famous and very well-known faculty of engineering. And part of what makes it so famous is it's a very unique program. Lakehead is the only university in Canada that in 4 years of study, a student can earn their full bachelor's of engineering degree, as well as an engineering technologist diploma. So they actually receive double credentials. And if they went anywhere else, it would take them 7 years minimum to get that same level of education. So we're giving students the full-fledged theoretical experience mm-hmm. of the engineering degree, but also the technical hands-on skills that that advanced diploma brings as well. Mm-hmm. We offer 5 core fields of engineering at Lakehead. So we offer chemical, civil, electrical, mechanical, and software engineering. And all of those areas also include the co-op and internship opportunities, mm-hmm. where students can work for up to 20 months as part of their engineering degree program. What is also really nice is for those students who complete their co-op, 1 year of that co-op actually counts towards their professional engineering designation.
Okay.
So normally when a student graduates from an engineering program, it takes 5 years of work experience to build up their skills and then ultimately to become a professional engineer in Canada. Mm-hmm. If they complete co-op with us, they only have to do 4 years of experience mm-hmm. afterwards, and then they can go for their licensing.
Fantastic. Mm-hmm. And we are very, very cost-sensitive country, right? So what is the return on investment for Indian students? So if they go and do take programs like business or engineering, what is the kind of pay packages they can expect once they get their first job?
So what we find is in the field, so let's say within engineering is a perfect example, typically like a mechanical engineering student, their starting salary, because they're still learning once they begin their career, is around $60,000 or so for a year. Mm-hmm. But once they're a professional engineer in the industry and they've achieved their career goals, that could be in the $180,000 category
oh, wow.
in terms of salary. So it is quite lucrative depending on what industry, what area they end up working in. And that seems to be typically across the board. In terms of like computer science students, you know, typically they'll start with even a bit of a higher salary, around sort of the $75,000 range is what we see statistically, what's available to students. And then they often will grow up to around $125,000 or so range,
very
depending
nice.
Again on the industry they're in. So these are very good, well-paying jobs, well-paying careers. The other area of academics I wanted to mention was computer science. So this
okay.
actually is another really area that continues to grow and has a much interest here out of India. I think that is a sign of some of the tech development and the high-tech industries here within India as well. But computer science at Lakehead, we do offer a number of different streams that students can choose from,
mm-hmm.
Whether it be hardware or software development, the business side of computing, and also even specialized areas like health informatics and new developments. Our computer science program is always evolving, which means they bring in new topics, whether it's ranging from artificial intelligence, security,
right.
Cryptocurrency, you name it, all of it, all of these new topics are being taught and always incorporated into the computer science program. And again, it also features that co-op and work internship. Mm-hmm. So a great opportunity for students to get involved in industry and have those exposures even while they're a student.
Okay, let's talk a little bit about weather. Is it true that Canada is always super cold? Or does it get any better for international students?
It gets much better. Canada, there's always this fear of the Canadian winter, right? And I think that no matter where I go in the world, whether it's India or anywhere else, there's always questions about this. Canada is definitely home to all four seasons. So we have wonderful springs, beautiful summers, nice crisp falls, and then we do have winter. Where we are located in Thunderbay on the northwest shore of Lake Superior, it's actually an interesting phenomenon that happens because Lake Superior is so large as a lake, it almost acts like an ocean.
Right.
So it actually tempers the climate and the environment. So our summers are quite lovely, but not too hot. Mm-hmm. So they can be anywhere from up to sort of 25 to 28 degrees in the summertime. In winter, we see average temperatures minus 15 degrees or so. It can get a bit colder on certain times of the year. But the good thing is that, you know, if you dress properly, you don't have to worry about the elements. Obviously, all of our buildings, homes, the university, everything is designed for the weather, right? Mm-hmm. So you don't feel cold in the winter because you're comfortable in your home, your residences, the classrooms themselves. In fact, many of our buildings actually have underground tunnels so that you actually don't ever have to go outside sometimes if it's particularly cold.
Do you have any advice for our students to be better prepared for winters?
You know, I mean, first of all, the number one thing is I would not recommend you buy a winter coat in India.
Okay.
Because given that there really isn't a lot of winter here,
the
likelihood of finding an appropriate piece of clothing for that is not there.
Yeah.
We actually see it as a bit of a rite of passage. You know, every year when students come and they move to Thunder Bay, one of the first big things they'll buy is a good winter coat. But I think overall, you know, I think generally speaking, you know, students obviously, it's how you dress is the most important thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and so addressing to the weather is the most important thing. We do help students understand around, you know, layering their clothes and things of that nature so that, you know, everyone is comfortable at the end of the day.
So you have thousands of students and so many international students also. Would you like to share maybe a couple of success stories with us today?
Yeah, I mean, we have so many students that have come from around the world and have a wide variety of successes that they've had. You know, one of the students that I think of right now, who just recently at Lakehead has actually joined our international team.
Mm-hmm.
His name is Vijay. He actually was supported by IDP in coming to Lakehead. And he was a student who graduated with his undergraduate degree in Chennai and was sort of looking for what the world would offer him in terms of opportunities. IDP helped him to find his way to Lakehead and to Canada. And he completed his master's degree, and he has actually now joined our international student advisor team, helping students from India and from around the world to come and transition to Lakehead. But Vijay was actually recently featured by the Universities Canada Federal Association in talking about his story of being an international student and the successes that he's had and how he's been able to establish himself.
IDP, as you know, is an expert in international education segment, and our counselors know quite a bit about everything, right? So everything related to international education. But they still get stuck sometimes. So they have shared a few questions with me, which I'm going to ask you.
Absolutely.
And I'll give you about 30 to 40 seconds to answer those questions.
Okay.
These are not very long, complicated questions, very straightforward. Mm-hmm. So the first question is, how can students reach Thunder Bay from Toronto? Are there any flight options, trains, or do they need to travel by road? So you did cover the flights part, so maybe...
So we would absolutely encourage all students to fly to Thunder Bay.
Mm-hmm.
And when students first land in Canada, many will come into Toronto. In fact, there's a number of direct flights from Delhi right to Toronto, so it's quite convenient.
Mm-hmm.
Once they receive their study permit and clear immigration, they would then get on a 1 hour and 30 minute flight and then ultimately land in Thunder Bay, where we'll be there at the airport to welcome them and bring them to campus.
So that brings me to the second question. What are some of the other arrival services that you offer to international students?
So Lakehead, you know, we really do value and we understand how important that pre-departure and departure experience is in terms of being successful when you arrive and start your studies in Canada. Mm-hmm. And so Lakehead offers a free airport pickup service to all of our students. Whether you're landing in Thunder Bay Airport or whether you're going to land at Pearson in Toronto because you're going to the Orillia campus,
right.
As long as you give us a few days notice, we'll make sure that we'll be there to pick you up at the airport.
Okay.
We bring you to campus, make sure that you get settled and everything is taken care of.
And is accommodation available on campus?
Absolutely. So Lakehead has accommodation on our Thunder Bay campus for over 1,200 students who live on campus, sometimes year-round. We have three different styles of residence available for students who want to live on campus. We have traditional dorm style residences mm-hmm. that include full meal plans where students can have all you can eat 7 days a week whenever you want, so it's all inclusive.
Okay.
But we also have apartments and townhouses, and these are more like family style living where mm-hmm. students have a private room and study space, but then they share a kitchen, a common living area, mm-hmm. and that can be a little less expensive because students aren't required to have a meal plan mm-hmm. and they can actually do their own cooking.
Okay.
So we find that for a lot of international students, they appreciate the opportunity to actually be able to do their own cooking. They can save some money. We have international grocery and superstores near the campus, so all of the spices, you name it, anything that a student needs.
What are the entry requirements of your MBA program?
So MBA at Lakehead, when it comes to graduate studies, is what we like to see as sort of a holistic approach to admissions.
Mm-hmm.
Students have to have completed an undergraduate degree, and we normally say the equivalent of a four-year honors or undergraduate degree in Canada. They need to have a minimum of a second-class standing or a B or higher,
mm-hmm.
Hopefully with no backlogs in that as well. Keep in mind, this is just the minimum to be considered for admission.
Right.
Doesn't necessarily guarantee admission, but it at least ensures that your application would be reviewed okay. by the faculty and be considered.
Mm-hmm.
MBA students also have to submit a resume. We want to see their curriculum vitae
mm-hmm.
and what their experiences are. They do have to do a personal statement as well around their intentions, their aspirations, and their experiences. And we do also require a GMAT or GRE as well
okay.
as part of admission.
Mm-hmm. All right. And is prior work experience a mandatory component of getting admission?
So for MBA program, we do hope to see at least 2 years of work experience
okay.
in a student's background. In fact, students with 5 years experience in either middle management or higher level are given a more preferred review in terms
mm-hmm.
of their assessment. But at the same time, as I mentioned before, you know, sometimes there are students who have exceptionally strong academics, you know,
mm-hmm.
our own Lakehead graduates who have done very well academically, but they have lesser work experience, you know, that may tip the scales in their favor.
Mm-hmm.
Or a student who maybe has good grades, but maybe not the top grades, but has exceptional experience in their background may tip the scales in their favor as well. So that's why I say it is a bit of a holistic approach when the faculty review those applications. They're looking for that well-rounded student and the balance in terms of offering them admission.
Okay, so that's the end of the questions that we had from counselors. What's your top advice to students? What are the things they should avoid so that they don't become ineligible for jobs in Canada or a career or a life in Canada?
You know, the most important thing at the end of the day is to follow the rules,
right?
So for every student who comes to Canada, they have to maintain full-time enrollment. They have to follow certain rules that Canadian government outlines. So long as they follow their rules, they don't take breaks in their study, you know, they need to maintain their full-time enrollment. If they do the right things, they follow the rules and regulations, then they should be on a good pathway towards being eligible for one of those work permits. But it's typically the students who have deviated from those rules that ultimately maybe find themselves in a difficult situation later on. But if students follow the rules and do what they're supposed to do, then of course they reap the rewards for that.
Yeah, I think it's absolutely spot on advice.
Yeah.
Well, Robert, thank you so much for coming to our show. I'm sure our students will really appreciate all the kind advice that you have shared with all of us here today. From the entire team at IDP, I sincerely thank you for your time and your effort today.
Well, it's been my absolute pleasure to be here today. Thank you for being such a wonderful host and for inviting me to take part in this. It's a great experience for me coming from Canada to be here and to share in this time with you as well. And on behalf of Lakehead, thank you to you and the entire IDP team for all that you do to help students, because we are very impressed and very happy with the quality of students and all of the preparation that goes into their candidacy for our institution. And we're nothing but happy with the relationship.
Thank you so much for your kind words.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
So that is it. from today's episode. Please like our social media pages and please leave your feedback. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.